In this video, I'm going to show you steps to color correct your video in Adobe Premiere Pro. You will be using the Lumetri Color panel along with some of the Lumetri Scopes. So why are we using Lumetri Scopes? Lumetri Scopes help us to get our colors and black and white levels correct. Also, they help so you're not relying on your eyes alone to make adjustments. So when talking about color correction, we're talking about exposure, contrast, and color balance. I'm sure you've heard the word color grading. That's something you probably want to do after you color correct. And color grading is a little bit more in the creative process. So we're going to go through a couple of steps to get you through color correcting. And the first step should be adjust your blacks and whites or your contrast. So I'm in the editing workspace right now. And to do my color correction, I want to come up here to where it says color and click on that. In the window on the top, I want to make sure my Lumetri Color and my Lumetri Scopes is checked. And here I don't have any Lumetri Scopes open right now, so that's why this window is blank. So first we're going to adjust something called the Luma. That's the brightness of your clip. And we're going to use something called the Waveform Scope. If I right click on this window where Lumetri Scopes is, if I come down to Waveform Type and click on Luma, and there is my Luma Waveform. On the left, you have your scale from 0 to 100. Up somewhere near 100 up here, you see your brightness and your highlights. They don't need to be all the way up to 100, somewhere around 80 to 90. Down here close to zero is where your shadows are going to be. Skin tones are somewhere around 60 to 70. So that's looking at the scope vertically. So if you look at the scope horizontally, it matches the clip as it goes from left to right. So if I play this, you can see the movement in the clip. And as she's lifting her head right there, you can see that right here at the top, there's more brightness or there's highlights. And that's right at the top of her head. Another example of this is here we have a parade and the ladies are marching. They're in the shadow of these buildings. And you can see the clip moving. All of a sudden the scene changed and part of them are marching into the sun. At the top of your Luma waveform, the brightness and contrast is all the way up there to 100. So this is an example of something that we would adjust. But this is one reason that you should look at the entire clip to see if you find spots like this where all of a sudden we're in bright sunlight. Now we're going back into the shadow to see the waveform. Everybody's in shadow. So here's the first clip we're going to work with. And we're going to use our Luma waveform. And you can see that this image, very flat and a sign of lack of contrast. The Luma waveform only goes from 20 to 60, so you want to stretch that Luma waveform across the dynamic range. So there are a couple of different ways that you can make this adjustment. You can use the exposure, contrast, highlights, shadows, whites and blacks over here in the tone. You can use these RGB curves over here, but we are going to use something called color wheel. And we're going to use the color wheel in combination with some of these exposure controls. I like using the color wheels. They give a good representation of your adjustment. And if you use Lightroom or Adobe Camera Raw, you see these similar color wheels in there too. So here we go. We're going to adjust our Luma, which is our brightness. We're going to use the waveform scope here. And it is set at Luma. First thing what would be good to do is come over here to the tone and the saturation. Take the saturation all the way down. That's going to help us see our Luma better. If you want to bring your saturation back to where it was, just double click on the adjustment. That puts it back to where it was. I'm going to take all the saturation out. We're going to come down to the color wheels. We're going to bring our shadows down. And you can see that the shadows are starting to come down on our waveform. Bring up the highlights. And then you can bring up the midtones. And the midtone adjustment's kind of more like a feel. And sometimes you have to go back and forth between your adjustments because they affect each other. And I'm going to play with the midtones there a little bit. And as you see, I'm scrubbing through the clip. And I can come back to my basic correction and double click on my saturation. I can bring up the saturation more. So here is the adjustment with just the color wheels. There is the before and there's the after. And then I can come back into the basic correction if I want. And I could bring down the black levels and Luma waveform is coming down towards zero. Could adjust my whites and I'm starting to spread this out more across the dynamic range. I could bring up highlights a little bit of contrast, a little bit of exposure, and then bring up my saturation. And that's about where I would have this clip. So you can use both together. Start off with the color wheel, and you can come back into the basic correction if needed. And we started out with a clip that was really flat, had no contrast in it. That's why we had to go to extremes to make all these adjustments. This example here of the parade, I would come to the color wheels and definitely bring down my highlights and maybe just the mid-tones a little bit, and then go through and see how it looks. I can bring up the shadows a little bit. But here I've taken care of that area where they all of a sudden go into the sun. You see the highlights are up here around 90. There's before and there's after. So to adjust your Luma in your clip, bring up the Luma waveform, and with the color wheel, start off by bringing the shadows down, then use the highlights color wheel, bring the highlights up, move the playhead in the clip, look for areas on the waveform that is near 100. You don't want it up that high. If there's a face in your clip, you want it about 70%, and use the mid-tones color wheel for mood and based on feel to see how it looks. Do me a favor, hit that like button. It really helps the channel. I appreciate it. So now we want to check our video clips for color balance or color cast. So now we're going to dial in our chroma values. Very important to go through and check your Luma values before checking your chroma values. I made an extreme example here of this color cast. You can make overall adjustments by the temperature and tint controls over here in the basic correction. The temperature control lets you adjust the chroma along the blue and orange spectrum, and the tint control lets you adjust the chroma along the magenta and green spectrum. But we're going to use our color wheels, and our color wheels are going to let us dial in the chroma or shadows, midtones, and highlights, adding or subtracting chroma values from these Luma ranges. And for this, we're going to use the Vectorscope YUV. If I right click here in the Lumetri Scopes and go to Vectorscope YUV, and I'm going to right click again because I'm going to remove our Luma waveform. So we just see our Vectorscope. I'm going to right click again because this brightness right here, I want to make sure that it's on bright. So there's normal. I want to be able to see it better. So I'm going to go down here to brightness and click on bright. So we're going to use our Vectorscope to adjust the midtones with our color wheel. And if I click in the middle of my midtones color wheel right here and move it around, you can see my Vectorscope moving. And as you go around this Vectorscope, there's yellow, red, magenta, blue, cyan, and green. So our values in this clip are pushing towards the green. So this is pretty saturated with green. Values near the center are less saturated, and saturation increases outward. So most of our skin tones are in the mid-tones. That's why we're using the mid-tone color wheel. And I'm going to take this the opposite way of green to magenta. And as I move towards magenta, you can see that all my values are starting to shift in my Vectorscope. If I come back into basic correction, if I move my saturation slider, my values start coming in. Too much saturation there, so I'll still bring it down. So now that we've used our Vectorscope to adjust the mid-tones, let's move on to another scope called RGB Parade. And we're going to use the RGB Parade to remove the rest of the color cast. I'm going to right click and click RGB Parade. I'm going to click on my Vectorscope because I want to close that and highlight that. And here's my RGB Parade. When you use the RGB Parade, you're removing color cast from the neutral colors in the image. So this shows the red, green, and blue in this clip. And if they're not equal, you have a color cast. Now to adjust for these chroma problems, you'll use the shadows and the highlight color wheel. So now if you look at your RGB parade in this clip, I'm going to have to increase the blues in order to remove the rest of the color cast. And this is going to be in the highlights. So if I click on my highlights color wheel and move this around, you see my blues start to come up. I might add that if you want to reset your color wheel, you just double click on your point and it goes back to the start. So I'm going to pull my blues up as high as it'll go, something like that. And if I need to, I can go back to my midtones and change that. And I can go back and forth and try to get my skin tones and my RGB parade as close as possible. So here is the before and here's the after. And that is color balance using your Vectorscope and your RGB parade. If I go back to this image where there was no real obvious color cast, if I go back to the Vectorscope YUV, looks like the midtones are starting to point out to cyan. So if I take the cyan and go the opposite way, so if I click on my midtones color wheel, you can see the movement on my Vectorscope. It's a small move. There's the before and there's the after. You can see I added a little bit more red. I can come back to basic color correction and I can bring my saturation down a little bit. You see there's the saturation changing. Okay, before and there's the after. But come back to the color wheels and I'll remove the vectorscope and there's still a little bit more red in here. You see at the top in the highlights. So I'll click on my highlights color wheel and the opposite of red is cyan. And if you look at the RGB parade, I'm bringing down my reds because I'm moving towards cyan. And here's the before. You see the RGB parade. The reds are way up near 100, more than the green and the blue. And here's the after. So that was an example where it wasn't really obvious there was a color cast, but there was. And we adjusted the midtones with our vectorscope and then came back to our RGB parade to make sure that our red, green, and blue was equal so that we didn't have any more color cast. If you want more tutorials like this, click or tap on one of the videos on the screen now. If you haven't already, subscribe, like, and share. And remember, it's never too late to learn. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.